All right, back at it. I cleared that the broken nipple out of the 45, and we're just not going to have that shutoff valve. If I decide I need that shutoff valve later, I'll add it later. All right. So, now to hook everything back up. All right, I went and got and assembled my makeshift tripod. Hopefully that'll work. Let's get this leveled out so that's not going to be an issue. All right, let's get you to look over here right quick. See if I can get you to stand at that angle. You see down there? Kind of, sort of. You see it? I can't see it. All right, that's right there. All right, we're gonna pull that forward just a little bit. All right, now I'm gonna get the generator and the angle grinder, and I'll be back to you. All right, I know where I need to cut, so I'm going to get to it. While we're at it, hey, we'll make this the review for the generator, too. I mean, it's all right. You got to sit level-ish in order to start. Every other time I've tried to start. So let's see. Come over here. You got to make sure it's in choke. Because if it ain't in choke, it ain't going to run. Open up the fuel. Way better than any extension cord, and way easier to move. Thank you. bleed all the air out of the line, out of that 90 footer right now. And I know we got more than 11 foot head pressure, so this big hook off here is about 5, maybe a little higher, whatever. Should be overflowing when it decides it's ready. Gurgling up there, so there's still air in the line. That's what we got going on right there. So we're flowing there. Yeah, so it's working. See that? Yeah, it blew all the mud and stuff that was in that pipe out. So now that I know that's working, I'm gonna set that rest of the stack pipe up. Well, the other section. Then go from there. Thank you.
and you better for you guys. See what I'm doing. More than 11 feet up there, you see it comes leaking out. And let's try this. Show you guys, try to show you guys what I'm doing here.
I'm short nipple or long nipple? Short nipple. See, I didn't get the closed ones.
Great. Oh yeah. You guys won't be looking at this, huh? But at the next part, yeah, I'm just gonna drain that off so I don't deal with the water flowing out while I'm trying to work. Alright, big thing to do, make sure the valve is going the right way. It's got a little arrow on it. This one we want facing upward, the other one we want facing down. I was going to buy a valve that lasts longer than the click-clack, but click-clack is, well, I forgot, so click-clack is what I had handy. Let's see here, can you guys see where I'm going to be working at? Yes, it's right about there. All right. I'm not using Teflon tape or pipe dope because it leaks it leaks. I doubt it's going to be a big deal because these pipes are already rusting. They've rusted together before, they'll rust together again. And rust is one hell of a sealing agent. And it's free. Now we're going to close it down so you guys can watch your fill again and start shooting out water as I go and grab the pressure tank and all that manifold assembly. Probably gonna switch out to smaller nipples when I get some, but this is what I had on hand, and you saw the issues I was having. So, Click click means there's air in the line yet, which of course there's air in the line. It's like 10 feet of air in the line. Now, if I had a foot valve, it would do this all on its own, and I need a sifter valve and for it to really do it well on its own. But you know what? I know an easier way to bleed out the air. This ain't hooked up to anything. This part usually takes forever. Well, I want to pause you guys for a second here. We'll come back when it's doing something. Okay, so I had to bleed that main line out again, bleed all the air out of it. But now we got it coming out of the standpipe where it does. It's over 11 feet high. And now let's try this again. Move you guys a little closer so you get a better view, maybe. Alright, there's still air in there, so let's open this up. You guys are getting wet too. Well, we'll come back after